स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दम् कृपापूर्णम् जगत्पतिम् हरिषड्वर्गजेतारम् नित्यानन्द गुरुम् भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दम् कृपापूर्णम् जगत्पतिम् हरिषड्वर्गजेतारम् नित्यानन्द गुरुम् भजे स्वभाव चिन्मय
सदाशिव समारम्भाम् शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तम् वंदे गुरु परंपराम्। We'll enter into the yesterday's questions first, then today's questions. This person is asking, can person enlighten only with idol worship? Oh, just with idol worship. I can say, you can become enlightened just with idol worship, but you must be able to develop that depth just through the idol, which usually does not happen. After a certain level, when the depth has become very deep, automatically the person moves to the higher levels or the deeper levels. So, if you are really kind of a person to the depth of Ramakrishna, then of course Ramakrishna didn't have anything else except that Kali idol. And finally Kali herself guided him to have the initiation from Totaburi. That's a very funny incident. Totaburi comes, is a great enlightened master, Avadhuta, Paramahamsa, no cloth, complete naked sannyasi, who lives with the nature. He comes to Dakshineswar and sees Ramakrishna and says, I feel you are an intense seeker. I want to initiate you. Ramakrishna says, wait for a moment, I'll go and ask my mother and come back. Totaburi thought maybe he is staying with his mother and he wants his mother's permission before the initiation. Ramakrishna runs to Devi temple and asks Devi, stands in front of the Kali Murti for 2 minutes and comes back and says, yes, my mother told, you have come here just to initiate me, initiate me. Totaburi was shocked. He said, what are you saying? You said you will talk to your mother and come back, but I saw you went to temple and stood in front of Devi Murti and came back. This guy said, yes, she is my mother. I asked her just now and she told me you can initiate me. Totaburi was sharp. And during the initiation, Totaburi said that bring your mind to the ultimate consciousness with no form. Centralize your mind on the formless consciousness. He gave some technique, actually initiated him into a very powerful sannyas technique, the sannyas initiation. But Ramakrishna says, no, I am not able to bring myself to that emptiness because the moment I close my eyes, the Kali is there in front of me. Then Totaburi says, then go and talk to your mother again. And the very interesting thing, he goes to mother and asks Kali, what is this? He is telling me to bring my inner space to the silence and to the pure consciousness which is beyond form. But whenever I close my eyes, I see only you. Then Kali says, go and follow his advice. That is the right thing you have to do. That is the right thing you have to do. And the story says, she gives her own sword. The sword which is she always carries and says, cut my form. Kill me. Understand, if you have that depth with an idol, then you don't need anything. usually when you have that depth with the idol, she herself will guide and take care that you became enlightened. That story says she herself guided him, gave the sword to cut him, cut herself, and Ramakrishna, when he again brought him himself back to the pure consciousness beyond form, he saw the form of the Kali and used that sword mentally and cut the form. And the story says he became enlightened. Understand? If you are at that depth, then naturally the deity herself, the devi herself will guide to you to the higher levels. When I stand in front of Krishna of Dwarika, I go speechless, thoughtless, and tears comes in my eyes. This does not happen in other kind of worship for me. It's perfectly alright. Even if it happens with one murti, that is okay. There is no problem. It's perfect. Just continue with that. That will take you to the deeper and deeper level. All I tell people, when you have the deep feeling of that one murti, just go with it. Have ishta nishta. Means that completely centered on that deity. Don't bother about anything else. You don't have to have that same experience in front of every deity. No need. Same way, don't say all other deities are useless. All other things are useless. All other gods are useless. Or all other techniques are useless. That is the only thing you need to avoid. If that one you can avoid, you will always be guided to higher and higher levels, deeper and deeper methods. All you need to have is depth, and the same way, openness for further updation. Openness for further experience. One small story about a Bhakta, a Vaishnava. Vishnu Bhakta. This guy is so devoted to Vishnu. Day and night he will do puja. And he will pray to Vishnu day and night. But somehow, Vishnu knows this guy is not just having pure love. This guy is more like attached or fanatic. More than the dedication or connection with Vishnu, he has too much of exclusing. You see, understand? Sometime, your devotion may not be a positive attachment. It may be the negative hatred towards other deities. The exclusion may be looking like a devotion. Anyhow, this guy was continuously praying, but Vishnu never gave darshan. And very funny thing, always with attachment, the problem is, if the other person does not respond, the whole your so-called love will turn as hatred. And this fellow's love became hatred now. Long, such a long time I prayed to you, you did not give darshan. I think you are useless. I'll choose some other god. Whom I'll choose? Your enemy. Shiva is your enemy. Supposed to be. Because these guys have their own idea. Shiva must be your enemy. I'll choose Shiva now. I'll not worship you anymore. And this guy put the Vishnu Murti to that one corner and cut hold of Shiva Murti and started doing worship. And he put the incense. When he put the incense, he saw, because of wind, the incense smell was going towards the Vishnu Murti. He got so annoyed, so irritated, he just jumped and caught hold of the Vishnu's nose. You should not smell my incense anymore. You had your share enough. You should not smell incense anymore. And now it is only for Shiva. Now I am trying with Shiva, experimenting with Shiva. I don't want you to take any of my smell. Half of the smell will go away to you. Then I may not get the full result. The moment he was holding the Vishnu's nose tightly, the story says suddenly Vishnu appeared to bless him. When Vishnu appeared, all his anger went away. He fell at the feet of Vishnu and cried and started asking, I prayed to you so many years, but you never appeared in front of me. Now I am working completely against you. am not only working against you, I am holding your nose so that you will not have smell of my incense, which I am giving for Shiva. And Vishnu says beautifully, all these years you worshipped me, true, but you never felt I am really living in this deity. Only when you started hating me and only when you held my nose that I should not have the smell of the incense, you sincerely from the deeper consciousness felt that I am in this deity. I am in this deity. Your hatred was deeper than the devotion. Your hatred could shake your being deeper than devotion. It may be hatred, but negatively, at least negatively, you had a deep faith for those few moments, I am available in the deity. I am there in that form. So that faith, I have to honor that faith, so I am appearing, I am blessing you. Understand? In this case, the fanaticism has paid. It has paid, but it does not pay always. So all you need to do, when you melt, go deep, be with it, but no need to hate or exclude other things. Be ready for deeper and deeper experiences, deeper and deeper explosions. She was